Hey everyone, welcome to the very first episode of Tech with Sach. My name is Sachin, a Google developer expert, and in this video, we'll be looking into how to build applications or actions for the Google Assistant. This is a series of videos focusing on developing for the Google Assistant. So without further ado, let's get started. So the first step is to head over to console.actions.google.com. So this is Actions on Google, which is a developer platform which helps you extend the functionalities of the Google Assistant. Go ahead and click on New Project and give a project name of your choice. So this would create a new project under the Actions on Google console, where everything that you need to do with your action or application for the Google Assistant is built in. And you'd be taken to a welcome screen with different themes. As you can see, you can build actions which fall under any of these categories, or in fact, you can also create custom conversational actions, which we'd be focusing on this specific video. We'll also be covering all of these other themes in the upcoming videos or tutorials. So go ahead and click on conversational action. Since we'll be building a custom action today, we'll be building a conversational action. And this is your Actions on Google dashboard. So to get started, click on the quick setup and you'd be redirected to add an invocation
name. Mr. Time Fixer.
So the invocation name is where you would choose what to call your action or application for the Google Assistant. You can also choose the different voices and go ahead and click Save. Once that is done, head over to Actions and click on Build Your First Action. And since we are building a custom intent in this case, a custom conversation, you can just go ahead and click on Custom and click Build. This would immediately shift your account to Dialogflow. Before that, we'll have to make sure we allow the permissions for Dialogflow to access our account. And once that is done, sign in with your same Google account that you've used to build your action. After that, the first step is to create an agent. Over here, we're gonna go ahead and create an agent. You can already see that the same name that we have mentioned for the project is already pre-filled from the Actions on Google console. Choose your language as well as the time zone and go ahead and click Create. So once we have created an agent successfully in Dialogflow, you would immediately be taken to this screen where you'd see two intents: the default welcome intent and the default fallback intent. So on the right hand side, you can also see as I type hi, you already get a default response. So this is actually coming from the default welcome intent. So in Dialogflow, intents and entities are the core components of designing a conversation. So in this case, it's as easy as training phrases, not coding. Here we are just designing our conversations. So we feed in what the user would typically say, and then we get a response back. So we can also type in the response under the responses section. So here you can see we have multiple responses. So if I go ahead and type in this default simulator that's available in Dialogflow, you can see the responses as well. So what are intents? Intents are basically, it categorizes an intent per conversation basis. So let's say you have different conversations. Dialogflow understands the intent of that specific conversation and then takes you directly to that specific intent. So in this case, when we say hi, it understands that it needs to go to the default welcome intent. Here, I'm gonna go ahead and change the response to a custom one since we'll be building an appointment scheduler in this case. So go ahead and add, make changes to the default responses or text responses in this case, and click on save. You can immediately see that our default response has reflected. So go ahead and click on intents. And let's go ahead and create a new intent. So the purpose of this intent is to make sure that whenever a user says, I would like to schedule an appointment or set an appointment at a specific date and time, our action should automatically understand that specific intent, identify the key items. So in this case, the ones that are highlighted in yellow are system intents. So it has automatically identified that this specific conversation has a date and time attached to it. So that's a system entity. So this system entity, as I mentioned, entities, what are entities? So here, entities are nothing but it helps us extract key information from our conversations. So let's go ahead and add a response. Sure, all set. Your appointment is set for, so we have to get the information, and each conversation is going to be different. So the way how we get that information is from this parameter value, which is dollar date and time. So let's save that intent. On the bottom right, you can also see that the agent training started and completed. So that's the machine learning model which runs behind the scenes within Dialogflow platform. So let's try that. So you can see I said set an appointment at 2:49 p.m. and it has automatically identified or extracted that key information. So the next step is to go ahead and integrate this with the Google Assistant. You can go ahead and click on integrations and then click on the Google Assistant tab. It would automatically come back to the actions on Google console where we have the test simulator where you can exactly test how your application would look like and respond. So if I say I would like to set an appointment at 4 p.m., we immediately get a response back. So we'll be covering a lot more in terms of the actions on Google console in the upcoming videos. And if you want to make sure that you set your intent as the end of the conversation, because we don't have any more conversations after this specific statement or response back from Dialogflow. So let's go ahead and try that again. So appointment at 5 p.m. Sure, all set. Your appointment is set for 5 p.m. And you can also see that Mr. Time Fixer has left the conversations. So that's how you basically end a specific conversation in Dialogflow. So I hope with that we have successfully completed how to build a simple chatbot or an action for the Google Assistant. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. We are just getting started. As I mentioned before, there's a whole lot of features and functionalities on how to build different conversational actions for the Google Assistant, as well as how you can integrate the Google Assistant into your own hardware devices. So I'll be covering a lot of those in depth in the upcoming videos. So make sure to click the like and subscribe button and also click on the bell icon so that you can be notified for the upcoming videos. I'll also be doing live sessions every week, so do join, where we'll be building an applications from start to finish. You can also tune in and ask me any questions or queries during that time as well. So hope you guys enjoyed the video and see you guys in the next one.